Hi guys, Innovative Pachyderm here, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Dinosaurs. Now, I've been a busy pachyderm off camera. I'm going to show you right now. So, off camera, I've been working on closing off the Plesiosaur Cove. And that's what I did. I built a little wall there and put some grass. I'm going to decorate it with some palm trees later. And I also did some more work on the viewing area for the plesiosaurs, because I realized there was kind of a problem. I started putting some of the coral down, the glow coral, and all these other corals down there. But from up here and here, you can't actually see the other coral. You can only see the glow coral. And I realized it's because we're not low enough in the water. Because the way the shaders work is that the higher you are in the water, the lighter it is and the darker. And then when you look down, it's really dark. So you actually have to be at its level for it to actually work. So you can actually see more of the other coral down there. See? And some of the kelp and seagrass. Now the reason I had to put a lot of glow coral is so you can actually see the bottom or the floor bottom. So I'm actually have to put some over there because it's a little dark. And then I can add a bit more, and I need to fix that part right there as well. Oh, and this part too, I just realized. But anyways, that's what I've been doing off camera. I am back from the Ender Dragon, or the end. The end dimension. There we go. That's where I was last episode to sort of celebrate this YouTube channel for reaching 500 subs. And that's a really big milestone, because that means we're like halfway to 1,000. And I can't wait for that to happen. There you go. So you can see over there. I need to put some glow coral here. Ouch. Okay. Can I actually place some here? Yes, I can. Just trying to place them in all the dark spots. Oh. Well, that was all my glow coral, and that's expensive because I have to buy that from the NPC. And I have them selling it for like 7 emeralds, I think. Should have done cheaper, but I thought it was fair. I need to put some here. Does this glow? You orange coral? Nope. I'm gonna need some there. I'm also gonna need. I wanna put more kelp. So I'm gonna break that. And does bone meal work on kelp? For Zawa? Ow. No, it does not. But it's a good thing that it grows like sugarcane. Or vines, and you could just break the bottom part and it'll drop the rest. So I'm just gonna spread this around. And I just came up with another idea of what I wanna do in the future for the ichthyosaur enclosure is do a whole coral reef themed enclosure for them. And I think I'm gonna have it in some sort of building, because I feel like that's the best way I can do it. I would totally do it like in the ocean, but that's just, I don't know. I feel like it's a little too much water for me to deal with and to get rid of. Even though I got sponges now, with all those, with all the what are they called? Sea temples that I found, I can actually use them. So actually might that be bad, but, it's still gonna be difficult. Oh yes, I actually love this. This is pretty cool. I really need some glow coral there though. So I'm gonna go to my storage room, where it's gonna be a little bit laggy. And we're gonna get me some of this iron. And then we'll go to the greenhouse, which is laggy as well. And we're gonna talk to Tenult, because she sells me more glowing coral. And I can't shift click, sadly, so I have to do this. I'm gonna spend all the iron that I just got right now on this. Even though I don't probably need that much, but in the future, I'm most likely going to need more glow coral, so might as well get it now. Ah! Get back here. Okay. Now, I can go back to the beach. Oh god, I'm in the ground. I need to change that waypoint, because I think this is slabs, and that's why that's happening. Okay, so I can see where I need to add more. Add here. We are here. Sorry, I like Horton Hears a Who. I feel like that would have been obvious. It's obvious why I like that movie. Because Horton is an elephant. Let's see. It's a little dark and shady here, but that's just because of the wall. Alright, so I'm gonna put more of these here. Oh! I also got, something else. Where's my bed? I put the bed in the chest, I think. Oh no, the bed's right here. Sleep really quick. Boop, 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 boop. I got some toys. I made three bubble blowers and a ball. Cause why not? I don't know if the ball's gonna work, but I'm gonna put that hole was there for a reason. And that's why. Ooh. Screenshot. Oh! Do I have no? I need to get respiration on my helmet. Where else? Let me see. I'm actually gonna look. Oh god, getting some frame rate. Low frame rate there. We're gonna go down here and see where would a. Where should a bubber blower be? Maybe one right here so you can hear it. Do I have my pickaxe on me? Yes, I do. Well, this isn't actually my pickaxe. That's the one I got from the end. But it'll do. Put that there. Ouch. Right there. Where else would be a good one? Maybe here. The far back. And then I'm gonna collect some more kelp. Okay. See, this is probably another reason. This is like another reason why I don't want to do the ichthyosaurs in an ocean, because I have to deal with a lot of drowning. Hey, at least it's not 1.13, and I don't actually have to worry about the drowned zombies. Which I just realized. How do drowned zombies work again? Are they just like zombies and they'll just spawn in dark waters? Or they spawn at night in the water, in the ocean? Like, what they do and how they do. Because if fossils or Jurassicraft or Reborn decide to go into 1.13 or whatever, but then they have aquatic creatures. Are the aquatic creatures going to be safe from trident throwing drowns? Because I'm pretty sure, like, the carnivorous... Ooh. Yes! Okay, I need to add one glowing coral right there, and it'll be perfect. I'm trying to make this as visible as possible in Minecraft standards. Because if this was an actual zoo, you'd most likely see a lot more. And it'd be a lot more clearer, too. Because if you've been to, like, a normal zoo, and you've seen, like, hippo enclosures, they have, like, a little glass. Sometimes they'll have a glass window in the water, and you can kind of see them. That's what I kind of want here. I need some right there. You know what? I think that's fine. This should be good enough decoration for the Plesiosaur Cove. Although I didn't add any of these. I'm gonna plop some of these down really quick, actually. Because I realize I've only been focusing more on the kelp and the glow coral that I haven't actually been planting the other type of coral. Oh, this coral's from the Zawa mod, and I had to go, like, exploring. Not too far, actually. I need to go in that direction. Because it turns out I haven't explored much of that direction. So a lot of the Zawa creatures and stuff were spawning there. So I don't actually have to teleport in that direction, where the volcano is. Staghorn. Elegant. And mixed coral. You know, I kind of want to put some... Ah! Right in front. Flying while underwater, like, really decreases your mining speed, I just realized. Ah! Place the sand and go back up. Okay. One here, put one there, there, there. Did I destroy glow coral? I think you can somehow destroy them. I don't mean to do that. Put one here. Oh god. Ugh. And then we'll add some seagrass. Right here and there. What? didn't know you can actually destroy them like that. That's kind of annoying. They kind of work like grass. Alright, let's give it one more look. Then you come over here. Yas! I approve. Pachyderm seal of approval right there. Oh god, okay. Now I kind of wish I did something better than just a ladder, but because of the space I had, that's all I could actually put. I'm not really good with applying like spiral staircases. But I think that should do, I guess. I don't know. Alright. So, let's go to the lab. Hello, Dr. Alan Grants. That I kidnapped. So I can get stuff from you. I didn't put the ball down, but it's fine. Let's see. How many plesiosaur do I have? 12. How many do I want to put? They're kind of small, so I kind of want to do 6? I want to do 6 of them. Oh my god, frame rate. It's horrible here. There we go. I kind of want to do, like, 4 adults. Let's make it 7. I want to do, like, 4 adults and 3 bubbas. I can use the chicken of essence. And do I have any of poison potato of essence? I don't. Did I put it in here? I'm gonna need a poisonous potato. Do I have any more I feel like I should have at least some. Am I just blind? Maybe I put it in the beach chest. I didn't. Okay, we'll just go back to the lab. Well, I'm gonna do a cut here, guys, till the incubators are done, or the plesiosaurs are done cultivating, so BRB, guys. Alright, they're all done, and it turns out I actually had 2 poisonous potato essence. They're actually upstairs, because a while ago I was trying to sort out my inventory because it was a total mess, and my backpack, which is getting to become a mess again, and I got lazy, so I just dumped everything, even fossils and archaeology stuff related, in some gold nuggets. So they were in that chest. So that means we're only able to give 2 of the plesiosaurs the poison potato essence, so they don't grow. Which I'm actually happy they added this in the mod, because now it gives people an opportunity to have some dinosaurs tiny, and you make potential petting zoos. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright, 7. Plesiosaurs. We'll just teleport to the beach. Hold up. I was cooking them. That's right. Low frame rate, because why not? My computer sucks. I probably have too much mods. Got some fish. Gotta feed the plesiosaurus fish or they'll be sad. Okay. So we're gonna do one, two, three. Four, five, six, seven. There you go. Fully grown. Fully grown. Fully grown. Fully grown. Fully grown. And now those two won't grow. Alright, now I'm pretty sure they're gonna be really hungry. Full. 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 Now when they're on the beach, they actually go to sleep, and that kinda like makes me feel sad a little. Alright, he's at a calm. Alright, so let's see. I don't need that many lasses on me, actually. Enjoy! Be free! Sort of. Oh god, why... frame rate. Every time I look in that direction. There we go. And I want one beached. Not really beached, but just... Oh, but do you have to look in that direction? Yeah, that's sort of okay. And then we'll have a baby sleep... Not sleeping, swimming there. Maybe one here. Whoops. There we go. Because, like, I think I said this in the last video. I kind of imagine plesiosaurs as seals, even though they're not really seals, but, like, I'd imagine them eventually coming out of the water just to bask in the sun. Just to warm up a bit. And I do remember when I was little seeing like a lot of dinosaur books and stuff that they'd always have images of like a lot of plesiosaurs on the beach, like seals or like on rocky beaches. My frame rate's getting horrible. Why? Let me come down here and you can see them. Ooh. I honestly think we need more plesiosaurs. Unless you guys disagree. Because they are quite tiny. I could add other creatures in here, like, not ichthyosaurs. Ichthyosaurs are gonna do their own thing. Maybe we can add sturgeon or some nautilus in here, just to give it some more life. Ooh, maybe some Zawa creatures can fit in here as well. I don't think a dolphin. Maybe a dolphin, actually. Dolphin and plesiosaurs, that'd be adorable. I don't know. You guys tell me. But I think that'll be it for this video, guys. So, if you liked the video, please make sure to hit the like button. If you have any more suggestions on what I can do for the plesiosaur enclosure or for the park in general, please leave it down in the comments. If you're new and like what you see, please make sure to subscribe. Also, if you want to learn more about the Reborn mod, a link will be in the description to our Discord so you can learn more about the Reborn mod. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Oh, just really quick, guys. Oh. Of course, just when I start recording. Oh, there we go. They actually carry the ball with them. That's so adorable. Oh my god. I love it. Look at them go.